Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 We're grateful. We're grateful. We're grateful to be in the house of the Lord on this evening. Amen. We thank God, amen, that he has kept us 365 days of this year. Hallelujah. Come on, tell the Lord thank you tonight. Hallelujah. What a faithful God we serve. Hallelujah. What a faithful God we serve. We honor the Lord and we thank him. Millions didn't make it, but we're the ones that who did. Amen. We've been through all through tests and trials and situations. Amen. Well, we felt that we wasn't going to make it, but we thank God for a faithful God. We thank him for being faithful unto us, but he would keep us through it all. Amen. Somebody said, I almost gave up. I almost threw in the towel. But the Lord still showed himself strong and mighty in our lives. Amen. Come on, one more time. Can we give God praise for being a true keeper? We serve a mighty God. We serve a faithful God. Hallelujah. There is truly no one like him anywhere. Amen. I wouldn't want to be anywhere but in the house of God on tonight. Amen. For the presence of the Lord, we find safety. We find strength. We find joy and we find peace. Amen. And we know by faith that God is going to allow us to make it into 2022. Amen. In our right minds, with the activity of all our limbs. Amen. Ready to run and do the will of God the more. Amen. Amen. At this time, we're just going to move forth into praise and worship. And we're going to invite the Lord in and welcome him into the house on tonight and create an ideal environment just for him. Amen. Somebody said, just for him. Hallelujah. God is so good. God is so good. Amen. Come on, worship the Lord with us this evening. Hallelujah.
Yeah. What a mighty God.
Surrounds me. My heart would not be afraid.
Yes.
Even if I am attacked, I will remain confident.
Thank you, Lord.
The one thing I ask of the Lord, the thing I seek most,
yes, Lord,
is to live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life.
Yes, Lord.
Delight in the Lord's perfections and meditate in his temple.
Yes.
And the word of the Lord is blessed.
Yes, 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 yes.
Heavenly Father God, we just come before you.
Yes.
Thanking you, Father God.
God,
you're a way maker.
Yes, you are. Yes.
Father God, you're a miracle worker.
Yes, you are. Thank
God, you're a promise keeper, Father God.
Yes, yes.
God, you're faithful, Father God.
Yes, you are.
God, you're loving, Father God.
Thank you.
Father God, you're consistent, Father God.
Yes.
God, you're just, Father God.
Yes, Lord.
God, you're everlasting, Father God.
Yes, Lord.
God, you are the Alpha and the Omega, Father God. The beginning and the end, Father God.
Yes.
God, thank you for all that you have done on this year, Father
thank
God.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank
Father God, we got great expectations,
yes.
Father God. Of the things, God, you have in store for your people on 2022, Father God.
Yes, Lord.
But God, thank you, God, that you seen fit, God. It was in your plan, God.
Yes.
That, God, we will be here at this present moment, God.
Yes.
Glorifying you, God. Lifting up your name, Father
yes.
God.
Yes.
God, we ask you, Father God, to send your protection, God, across this nation, God.
Yes,
across this world, Father God.
Lord.
Across the city of Memphis, Father
yes,
God.
Lord. Yes, Lord.
God, we believe a mighty word will take place in your house on tonight,
yeah,
Father God.
Yeah, God.
Be with the man's servant, Father God.
Yeah.
Shield and protect him, Father God.
Yeah.
God, speak to him, Father God.
Yes,
God, speak through him, Father God. Speak for him, Father God. God, thank you for Lady Bailey. God, thank you for his children, God. Thank you for the children of restoration, God. God, thank you for the musicians, Father God. God, thank you for all that's present right here, Father God. God, thank you for those that's watching right now, Father God. God, comfort them right now at this time, God. Love on them, Father God. God, encourage them, Father God. But God, we just want to tell you thank you, God, for it all. Thank you for everything. But God, we just want to honor you and bless your holy name.
Yes,
in Jesus' name we pray.
Jesus
amen.
Name. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. You see the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. We're excited about going into 2022. Amen. Amen. We're going to spend our evening giving God praise and worship and just going deeper into his word on tonight. Amen. Amen. We ask that you are still to worship with us. Amen. And create an ideal environment for our Savior. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
is no other way that I can live without you. I've tried over and over and over and over again. Burdens, they're just too much for me to bear. But thanks be unto God who's with us, who loves us, who empowers us, who keeps us. Thank God for his spirit. Come on, while we're here tonight, come on, let's clap. Let's open our mouths. Let's give God. In fact, fact, I'll just go a little bit further. Let's start at verse 4, and I'll read fast, all right? And being assembled together with them, he commanded them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, which he said, you have heard from me. For John truly did what? Baptized with water. But you shall be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days from now. Therefore, when they had come together, they asked him, saying, Lord, will you at this time restore the kingdom of Israel? And he said to them, it is not for you to know times or seasons, which the Father has put in his own authority. But you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses of me in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the end of the earth. God, we thank you,
yes, Lord. Thank you.
For this opportunity to be found in your presence. We don't take it for granted, God.
Thank you.
You've allowed us to make it.
Thank you.
It's the last day of the year.
Yes.
We realize, oh God, that purpose for our lives is yet to be fulfilled.
Yes.
We realize, oh God, that the plans that you have for us are still manifesting. Tonight we do not take it for granted, but we say thank you.
Thank you, Father.
Because we realize it could have been the other way.
Yeah. Thank you, Lord.
And if we were honest,
hallelujah,
we tell you thank that you, it should have been
Jesus
the other way.
Yeah.
But thank you for Jesus, your grace.
Yeah.
Thank you for your mercy.
Thank you
for
Lord,
your
thank
loving
you,
kindness wherewith you have drawn us.
Glory to God. Thank you.
To be here tonight, God, we say, is amazing.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
It's a miracle.
Yes, Lord.
And we thank you.
We thank you right now.
Feed us tonight.
Feed us tonight, Lord.
Speak directly to us,
yes,
individually,
God,
and collectively.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Thank you for those that are here, God, and those who are watching on tonight.
Yes, sir.
Father, heal this land.
Heal the land, oh God. Yeah,
heal
God,
this land.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
There's all kind of sickness going on.
Oh God.
Heal the land.
Yes, Lord.
In the name of Jesus. We tell you that we love you and we bless you.
Yeah, God.
Amen.
Amen.
Take your seats with a shout.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I want to talk to us from the Sunday title on tonight, Power for Living.
Yes, God.
Power for living. We're in a world now where we're faced with so many decisions and choices in which we must make physically, mentally, and no doubt spiritually. And in making these choices, we need guidance.
Amen. Oh, yes.
We need the Holy Spirit to lead us. And the Bible says that he is the Spirit of truth to guide us into all truth, so that we will not lean to our own understanding. But in all our ways, we'll acknowledge him, and he'll do what? He'll direct, he'll guide our path. Jesus has been resurrected through him by the power of the Holy Spirit. And being so, he is there with the disciples 40 days after resurrection. He is speaking with them, giving them directives concerning their mission, the plan in which he has for them as it pertains to becoming witnesses of him in the earth and carrying out the gospel to the ends of the earth. The question is asked by Peter. Are you at this time getting ready to restore Israel and set up your kingdom in the earth? Jesus says something that I think that is very remarkable. He said, it's not for you to know times and seasons. He goes further to say, watch this, the Father has placed it in his own authority. Which means that I can't even speak on it. He says, but the Father has placed it in his own authority, whereby he shall come back into the earth and restore Israel, whereby he shall come back into the earth and bring all things unto him, subduing all things unto him.
Yes.
But here's the thing that we need to understand. Jesus says, he says, I need you to wait until you are what? Endued with power. He says, there at Jerusalem, he says, power is going to come upon you. Now, here's the thing that we got to understand. The Bible says that God, in his own authority, has set things up. Yeah. So therefore, because he has authority, he is authorized to give them power.
Yes, come on.
Y'all didn't hear me?
Yes, sir.
Because he has authority, he is authorized to give them power.
Yes.
And many of us, watch this, we have power, but we've not been authorized.
My Lord, come on.
No, y'all ain't talking to me here. And you can tell when somebody who's operating in power who has not really been authorized to work in that power or operate in that power, they would become abusers of that power.
Yes, sir.
You got to be careful with power, because power, absolute power, literally exposes the heart of an individual. It exposes the motives of an individual. It exposes the character of an individual. So Jesus was very careful about who he gave power to. He was careful about who he gave authority to. He was careful about who he authorized in the earth. And we'll read in the scriptures on tonight where we'll find that there were others who were of this way as it pertains to disciples, but they did not receive the power, the dunamis power. Because the word power here is actually translate dunamis, which means he gave them dynamite.
Come on now. Yeah.
He gave them power to tread upon serpents and scorpions. And he says that they could eat poison, they could drink it, and it would not hurt them. I don't suggest that you go out and drink poison. I don't suggest that you go out like some religions and take up serpents. Amen, somebody. I don't suggest that you do that, but you got to understand, like Paul. When Paul was sitting there at the fire and the Bible says a viper jumped out of the fire and latched onto him, the Bible says that he shook it off. Why? Because the weapon can form against you, but it will not prosper, because you have power on the inside of you. And if you're going to live the Christian life, you need power for living this life. You cannot live it in your own strength. You cannot live it the way you desire to live it. You got to live it the way he designed for it to be lived. And so we see the disciples who have been empowered. They are ready to receive what it is that the Lord has for them. And then suddenly, after the Lord gives them directives and after the Lord gives them the information about what's getting ready to happen, he's gone. And this is why it's important. And this is why I love Paul. Paul says, even in my absence, even in my absence, he says, I want to see you operate in what you've been taught. And what happens is when the leader is out sometimes, Lord have mercy, and people have been delegated some sort of authority or power, they become abusers of that. But I thank God for the apostles, because they are examples unto us that when Jesus gives you a directive, when Jesus gives you an order, when Jesus gives you a mandate, that it's, you're capable of living it out. That if you learn how to hear, the Bible says in Romans 8 and 14, for as many as are led by the Spirit of God, these are the sons of God. Yes. What is happening in our earth right now is the church is no longer looking for the Holy Spirit. They're no longer craving for power. They're no longer craving to do exploits. The Bible says when Jesus was in the earth, he gave the disciples power to cast out demons. And everywhere they went, people were healed. Demons were cast out. In this day and time, all we want is entertainment and performance in the church. We need power in the church so that people can come back to the church. This is why sinners do not look to the church anymore, because there's so much entertainment and performance in the church. But whenever there is power being displayed in the church, whenever the Holy Spirit is in operation in the church, it will reveal the hearts of sinners, and they will come asking, what must we do to be saved?
Yes.
We need the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
We need power.
Yes, we do.
For living.
Yes. Yes.
I don't want to live on my own, because if God gives me over to myself, I become destructive.
Right,
I need somebody, I need something that is greater than me, that can live within me and help me regulate myself.
Come on.
And some of us don't understand self-regulation. That you got to be able to command yourself to not do a thing under the authority of the Holy Spirit, through and by the power of God. When you do so, then you can bring yourself into alignment with the word of God. Paul says, I know within my flesh dwell no good thing. What is he saying? I've got to subject myself to a higher power.
Yeah.
I've got to subject myself to the authority of God.
Yeah.
And so here's the thing that we need to understand. One of the reasons today many people do not want the Holy Spirit is because they understand that he cannot dwell in an unclean temple. That he's not going to share you. That the Spirit of God and Belial, they cannot live together. That God will not dwell in a clean, in an unclean temple with an evil spirit. Not that, listen to me, not that we are righteous in and of ourselves. We need the Spirit of God within us to keep us and to cleanse us. Remember, we've been washed, we've been sanctified, and we've been justified. And the only reason that happens is because the Holy Spirit has come and take up residence within us. We've availed ourselves to him. And when we avail ourselves to him, whatever it is that we ask, Jesus says in his name, he says he will do it. Why? So that the am I hearing God tonight?
Yeah.
We're going into a new year. We're on the brink of a new year.
Yeah.
And many of us, we've encountered some failures in 2021. We've encountered some heartaches and some disappointment.
Yes.
In fact, we've let ourselves down more than we've let God down. We've let ourselves down more than we've let others down. And we've experienced some setbacks. But I come to tell you today that God can give you this power. That will reside on the inside of you. God can give you a power going into this new year, that whatever you failed at, wherever you failed in 2021, he will give you the authority to step over it, that you don't have to continue in this cycling behavior, that there is some power readily available to you tonight. If you are willing, the Spirit is able. That's why Jesus says to his disciples, he says, listen, he said, the flesh is weak. He said, the flesh is weak. He said, but the Spirit, what? The Spirit is willing. The flesh is weak, but the Spirit is willing. That's why, again, we say, for as many as walk by the Spirit of God, these are called the what?
Sons of God.
That you got to be led by something and somebody that's greater than you. Oh God, hallelujah. I'm thanking God that he's allowing me to make it to the end of this year, that as I'm going into the new year, I can say, God, I thank you that where I failed you in 2021, you gave me grace. I thank you that where I failed others in 2021, you gave me grace. I thank you that where I failed myself in 2021, God, you gave me grace. So because you gave me grace, and because your Spirit dwells and lives on the inside of me, in 2022, I'm going to fulfill all that you have for me. In 2022, God, I'm going to make you smile. In 2022, God, I'm going to make you proud of who I am. Watch this.
Thank you, Lord.
And so when we look at the disciples, power for living, Jesus understood the conflict and the chaos that was ahead for them. He knew that we needed the Holy Spirit. There are too many people in the church today who say they're saved, But watch this. They don't crave for Holy Spirit.
Uh-huh. Come on. Come on.
Now I want to say this. Let me let you understand. Everybody that's saved, listen, have the Holy Spirit.
That's right. Mm.
He's the keeper. Uh-huh. You can't be saved except he draw you. So everybody who is saved have the Holy Spirit, but not everybody who is saved have the gifts of the Spirit. It's a difference.
Yes.
And so we have, watch this, we have natural people, we have spiritual people, mm-hmm. and we have carnal people.
Yeah.
Say it one more time, baby. We have natural people, mm-hmm. we have spiritual people, and we have carnal people. Natural people are people in whom the Spirit does not dwell in because they reject him.
Right.
Spiritual people are those who have accepted the Holy Spirit and allowed him to come and take up residence. Yes. The Bible says, watch this, that we are the temple of God and the Spirit of God dwells in us, and whomever destroys this temple, him will God destroy. And so the Bible tells us, watch this, as believers in Christ, watch this, he who has an ear, let him hear.
Yes.
What the Spirit says unto the church, and we realize in 1 Corinthians 2nd chapter, the Bible says, those things which are spiritual,
yes.
carnal men cannot discern them.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because they're through the Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have the carnal man. The carnal man is the man that lives. Watch this. He's saved. And the Spirit dwells in him, but he lives like the natural man.
Mm-hmm.
Lord have mercy.
Come on, sir.
Carnality is a spiritual term that speaks of worldly behavior.
Mm-hmm.
In other words, that saved people acting like unsaved people.
Yes, sir.
Who are in God. In other words, he says, watch this. He says, you're not really who you say you are.
Mm-hmm.
Watch this. You're saved, but you're not safe.
Right. Oh, right. Mercy. Right.
Because all you have is a form mm-hmm. of God. So watch this. You're saved, but you're not safe. And if you're saved and you're not safe, it's not safe to die.
Amen.
Can I say one more time? You're saved, but you're not safe.
Mm-hmm.
Which means you're not safe to die. It's not safe to die. I said, which simply means this. Being saved is to be bought with a price.
Yeah.
Being saved is to be, watch this, be rescued, salvation, mm-hmm. to be rescued from the penalty of death.
Mm-hmm.
The wages of sin is, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Watch this. So many people are saved, but they're not saved.
Right.
And the reason they're not saved is because they're drifting.
Yes, sir.
The analogy I want to give you is a boat that is tied and anchored to the dock.
Mm-hmm.
But it begins to drift.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Come on.
And even though it's tied to the dock, it's drifting.
Mm-hmm.
And the more waves that comes in
mm-hmm.
causes the boat to rock to and fro.
Mm-hmm.
James said it like this. He says, let no man think that when he asks of God for wisdom and he is doubting that he will receive anything
mm-hmm.
from God. For he's a double-minded man, unstable in all of his ways. He's like the waves of the sea, tossed to and fro. So watch this. It's anchored, but it's drifting.
Yeah.
And the greater the waves come in, the more it causes friction, God have mercy, in the anchor. And eventually, the anchor gives way and the ship is out in the midst of the sea. And if the storm comes and the ship is not anchored, it can be destroyed. That's the same thing with our souls. And so tonight, we need power for living.
Amen.
I don't just want to come to church no more.
Come on, sir.
I want to experience God.
Oh, yes.
I know it's Sunday, but I just don't want to show up for Sunday morning service. I need an encounter with God.
Yeah.
I, I don't just want to show up. I want something to be changed within me. I don't just want to be showing up. I want God to use me mightily.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And this is what is going on in the life of the apostles. They've given themselves thoroughly to God. Not that they've not made any mistakes or they've not fallen along the way. No, what it simply means is because they are saved. It doesn't mean that they are sinless. It means that they sin less. And in sinning less, it simply means that they have been governed by a higher power so that when they sin like David, they can turn to God and says, God, against thee and thee only have I sinned.
Yeah.
And they can ask for forgiveness. Uh-huh. And so tonight, watch this. Some of us have dethroned God and enthroned self.
My Lord.
And wonder why our lives produce and see so much chaos and interruption when it comes to the promises and the blessings of God. The Bible tells us that the promises of God, they are yes and amen. And that the blessings of the Lord make it one rich and adds no sorrow. Yet, we are inclined to lean to our own understanding. When life gets tough and we're seeking immediate action to shift and change our circumstances. I don't know why I'm saying circumcision. Circumstances. Somebody shout, we need to be circumcised in heart. Praise the Lord. We do not implore the Holy Spirit to take control of our lives and possessions of our lives. We selfishly and recklessly depend on the arm of flesh to deliver us. Jeremiah 17:5 says this, watch this. Curses the man that trusted in man and make it flesh his arm, whose heart departs from the Lord. Zechariah 4:6 tells us that it's not by might, nor by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord of hosts. When we insist on living in our own strength, we lack the ability to properly guide and steer our lives in the direction of peace and safety. And this is why we need power for living. It is the Holy Spirit who empowers us to live the godly, empowered life. Yeah. Think about the apostles who did not regard their lives even until death. That when they were out, they were preaching about the word of God. The Bible says, watch this, they were beaten for the name of Christ. The very name they were told not to preach in, they went right back in the temple and began to preach in that name. Why? Because Peter asked the question, who are we to obey, God or man? I'm telling you, there is something that is coming upon this earth. And many of us do not recognize it, and many of us do not understand it. But there is such evil that is coming upon this earth. And we are getting ready to see it in the political world. Y'all ain't hearing what I'm saying? It's about to bleed over into the church. Y'all ain't hearing what I'm saying? And everybody who's looking for a popular message, everybody who's looking for something to make them feel good, everybody who wants to hear a message to tickle their ears and cause them to leap and jump, you can jump up empty and sit back down empty. In this day and time, you need something that's going to keep you. You need somebody that's going to keep you. You need to be convicted when you're in your convenience. You ain't hearing what I'm saying. When you don't think that it's time for you to get up and do the will of God, you need something that will convict you and pull you out of your do-nothingness and cause you to come back to God and say, God, I have failed. God, what must I do to be empowered again? We're living in a day and time that if you ain't got the Holy Spirit, any and everything's going to come up and through you and cause you to be tossed to and fro with every wind of doctrine. The Bible says, the man who is not in control of his spirit is like a city without walls. You need the Holy Spirit.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
We don't even teach about the Holy Spirit no more. Yes. You don't hear about the Holy Spirit in church. And then if you do hear about it, it's just about tongues.
Come on.
They're greater gifts. Mm-hmm. But more important, we need the Holy Spirit. Because he is our keeper. He is our paraclete. He walks with us. He empowers us. He enhances our lives.
Yeah.
When I say power for living, I'm not talking about physical power. I don't care how strong you are physically. That's not the power that I'm talking about.
Come on, sir.
I'm talking about spiritual power.
Yeah.
That comes directly from God himself by way of the Holy Spirit. Somebody shout, we need
a
power.
Power.
Operating in and over us that's greater than us.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
We need a power that's operating in us and over us. Someone who is greater than us. We need the Holy Spirit. 1 John 4:4 tells us, watch this, that greater is he that dwells in us than he that dwells in the world. What is he saying? The greater one is within you.
Yeah.
He's talking about the Holy Spirit so that you can recognize a false prophet.
Yeah.
He's talking about the Holy Spirit. So that when sickness and disease come upon your body, you can speak by his stripes,
yeah.
I am healed. Yeah. So that when sickness and disease run throughout the church, we can say in the name of Jesus, we are healed. We shall live and not die. And we can speak the word of God in and over our lives, in and over our family. Why? Because we got something and someone who is greater on the inside of us. I'm not waiting for the next nothing. I am all that God is going to do in this earth. Everything that God wants to do, he's going to do it through me. I'm not waiting for the next preacher, Lord have mercy. I'm not waiting for the next prophet. I'm not waiting for the next summons. I'm not waiting for the next move of nothing. I'm not waiting for the next wave. All that God wants for me, it's inside of me.
Yeah, yeah.
And some of us were dormant.
Come on, sir.
But God wants to give you more.
Help us, Lord.
Somebody shout, God wants to give you more. Listen
Thank
to me.
The Lord.
When you understand the necessity of the Holy Spirit, as the disciples did, they understood the necessity of the Holy Spirit. For he was the promise to come who would empower them for service.
Yeah.
To be witnesses of Jesus in the earth and to do exploits. That's why we need the Holy Spirit. That's why many of us, we ain't witnessing.
Mm.
We need the Holy Spirit to witness. Jesus says he will bring all things to your remembrance. Jesus says he will not come and speak of himself, but he will glorify me in the earth.
Yes, yes.
That's why he says, in the hour in which you shall speak, think not what you shall say, for I shall give it unto you.
Yes.
And when we get to that place in life where we feel as if, watch this, we're forgetting, listen to me, I'm going to tell you, we're not forgetting, we're forfeiting. Y'all didn't hear what I'm telling you. We're not forgetting, we're forfeiting. What do you mean we're forfeiting? What do you mean we're forfeiting? I mean that you're not forgetting, you just simply become so slowful and lazy in your life that you're not desiring the sincereness of the word that you may grow thereby. I thank God for conviction. I don't want to forfeit. I don't want to forget. I want to be on the forefront of God's word, of God's line, doing his will. Somebody shout, you're not forgetting, you forfeiting.
Come on now. Help us. Help us.
I keep forgetting. God said, no, you're not forgetting, you're forfeiting.
Wow.
And the reason you're forfeiting, because you don't read. You don't study. You don't fast. You don't pray. I had to tell my wife today, I said, I feel so ashamed. Y'all don't want to talk to me in here. I feel so ashamed because we can get so busy. We can get so busy and so far removed away from what God has called us to do. That we don't have time for God.
Yes, sir.
Y'all religious folks ain't got to say nothing to me in here.
Come on now. Come on.
I thank God that in my conviction, he was able to put me back in the right direction.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
I know what it is. I'm not talking about as a lay member. I'm not talking about as a musician or a summons. I'm talking about as a pastor.
Yes, sir. Come on now.
I know what it is as a pastor to be standing right here to get so busy with life.
Yes, sir.
Come on. That I'm removed from the things of God.
Yeah.
And it's that much more harder to get back into the groove of things.
So,
you wonder, Lord, why can't I remember? Lord said, it wasn't so important to you then. Whatever is important to you, you will keep it at the forefront of your life.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Am I helping anybody in here tonight? And so watch this. The disciples knew that the Holy Spirit was the promise to come. That's why it's important that we understand. Watch this. Lord, everybody who say they with you ain't for you.
Come on now.
Everybody who say they for you ain't necessarily with you. Lord, y'all gonna make me jump in my notes, and I ain't got nothing but a couple of more minutes, but somebody shall hold that. Hold that thought.
Yeah.
The disciples understood the necessity of the Holy Spirit. They knew that it was going to be the Holy Spirit who would cause them to do exploits in the earth. Mm-hmm. When was the last time somebody was sick in your presence?
My Lord.
And you laid hands on them? Mm-hmm. Lord, y'all ain't talking to me.
Come on.
The Bible says, bring the sick to the elders of the church. You ain't got to be an elder. Are you not a minstrel? Bible says we can pray the prayer of faith and they would be healed.
Yes, sir.
Bible says, whether two or three gathering in my name, touching and agreeing, that I am a God in the midst.
Where's truth? Where's truth?
We don't trust God's word until we're down to nothing.
Come on, say that. That's the truth right there. Come on.
The preacher just read tonight, when the enemies and my foes come upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumble and fail. Though a host shall gather themselves around me, he says, my heart will not fear.
Yeah.
One thing have I desired.
Yeah.
That will I seek after. Uh-huh. That I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. You can't dwell in the house of the Lord powerless.
Come on.
You need keeping power. Old folks used to say, you need some keeping power.
Yes, God.
We're
yes,
talking
Lord.
In here.
Yes, Lord.
So Jesus told the disciples in John 14 and 12 through 14, watch this, most assuredly, I say to you, he who believes in me, the works that I do, shall he do also, because I go to my Father. And whatever you ask in my name, he says, that I will do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If you ask anything in my name, Jesus says, I will do it. The question is, when was the last time you asked something in his name?
Mama.
Apart from God, his Christ, and the Holy Spirit, we can do nothing.
Yes.
We need the right power to make the right decisions and choices in life. We need the right power to make the right choices and the right decisions in life. Some of y'all coming here, y'all are looking for, you know, God going to do what he going to do for you in 2022. Some of y'all came here looking for that new house in 2022.
Teach us the word.
Looking for that husband that you ain't even prepared yourself for.
My Lord.
We look for, watch this, unnecessary things.
That's right.
While forfeiting the necessary. I'm telling you that if you're gonna live right, we living in the last days.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
And church folks still walking around with no Bible.
That's true, sir. That's true.
We living in the last days and everybody still talking about doing me. We need power.
Amen.
Yeah.
That's why our churches are empty. We need power. That's why we're weak. We need power. That's why we're without. We need power. And if I got a shouter from the mountaintop, I'm going to shout it. Thank God that I did not sign up for popularity. Thank God that I didn't sign up to preach cute sermons. Lord, have mercy.
Come on.
Thank God that I don't get worried about likes on Facebook. Lord, yeah.
Come on, man.
Thank God that I don't get bent out of shape for followers. Thank God that I can sit still, amen, and say, God, I'm doing your will. If they rejected God, that's still. I don't care if it's family or it's church. I don't care who it is. Nobody would ever be able to stand before God and say, God, he did not tell us.
My Lord. Amen. My Lord.
I'm your Ezekiel.
Come on now.
Blood won't be on my head.
That's it.
Give us your name, take your name. We need power.
We need power.
Power for living.
Yeah.
I remember when people were walking in the church, amen, somebody, and they had a disease or they had a sickness, amen. They would come to the altar and the elders and the wealthy women in the church, y'all ain't talking to me. Missionaries and mothers and diggers, they come and they get to lay it in. And we used to see wheelchairs hanging on the wall.
Yes.
I used to go in church and say, why the folk got their wheelchair up there on their wall?
Oh, come on.
Evidence that the Holy Spirit still working.
Yes.
Look at your name, Michelle. We need the right power.
We need the right power.
To make the right decisions.
To make the right decisions.
We need the right power
yes,
to make the right choices
yes,
in life.
Lord.
We're going into a new year.
Amen.
Uncharted territory.
Yes, sir.
That's never been explored.
Yes.
And unless we have the Spirit of Truth as our God to empower, equip, enhance, and enable us to do the will of God, we're going to utterly fail. Somebody shout, all year long.
All year long.
Jesus said to John in John 16 and 13, he says, when the Spirit of Truth comes, He will guide you into all truth.
Yes, Lord.
There are some things up the road ahead of us that if we're not rooted in the Word of God and the Spirit of God is not leading us and we have not succumbed to His will, we're going to succumb to distraction, detours, and defeat.
Yes.
Somebody shout, we got to be careful.
Lord,
have mercy. I'm getting ready to go. Watch this. I can't give y'all what I want to give you, but watch this. Somebody shout the main two reasons.
Main two reasons.
Watch this. Some of us don't understand how much God is desiring to use you as an individual in the earth. How much He's desiring to use you as an individual in the earth. But God cannot use you if you don't avail yourself to Him.
Come on now. Come on.
The main two reasons God gave the disciples power was number one, to do what? Fulfill His promise.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
He told them that the Holy Spirit will come. And number two, that they might become witnesses of Him throughout Jerusalem, all Judea, Samaria, and the uttermost parts of the earth, even if it costs them their lives. The question is, when God gives you His Spirit, are you willing to lose your life for God?
My.
When the Holy Spirit is in you, and you experience conflict and adversity, are you willing to lose your life for Him? The apostles were willing to lose their lives. Mm-hmm. All of the apostles were martyred, with the exception of John the Revelator. He was boiled in hot oil by way of a failed execution and was exiled to the island of Patmos.
Yes, sir.
For whatever reason, so many today have forsaken the promise. But Peter exclaimed to those who were standing round about him at the day of Pentecost, as he was preaching in Acts 2 and 39, he said, for the promise is to you and to your children. Y'all hear that?
Yes.
The promise is to you and to your children and all who are afar off, as many as the Lord our God will call. Many are called. But few are chosen. I want to share this with you real fast. I want you to go to Luke 10 real fast. I want to share this with you. I'm about to send you home. Let you eat your last meal for 2021. Before we go on this fast.
Praise the Lord.
I don't know which others. Somebody says steak and potato. No, somebody say pancakes. All right. But I want to show you something. Luke 10, are you there? Look at verse 18, watch this. And he said to them, I saw, in fact, number 17. Then the 70 returned with what? Joy, saying, Lord, even the demons are subject to us in whose name? And he said to them, I saw Satan fall like lightning from heaven. Behold, I give you authority. I'm giving you power to trample on serpents and scorpions and over all the power, not some of the power.
Oh, okay.
but all of the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means do what? Hurt you. Nevertheless, do not rejoice in this, that the spirits are subject to you, but rather rejoice because your name is written where? In the Lamb's book of life. Now verse 17 says, 70 return. Isn't it right? Go to John 60. John 6 and verse 60. That's why I'm telling you, everybody who say they with you ain't for you. Everybody who say they for you ain't with you. Watch this. See, in fact, I want to bring you down to verse 53. This is why it's important for you to understand Revelation and have revelation knowledge of the word of God. Watch this. Then Jesus said to them, most assuredly, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in you. Good God. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life. And I will raise him up at the last day. For my flesh is food indeed, and my blood is drink indeed. He who eats my flesh, that's kind of controversial. I remember some years ago, I won't say the preacher's name, but he was very controversial, and he was preaching from this text, and he named the text, his text was, eat me. A lot of people started leaving the church. And ain't that what Jesus just said? I'm not going to call his name, amen, but if anybody, they know who I'm talking about. He know he, all right, so watch this. He said, he who eats my flesh and drinks my blood abides where? In me. And I where? Why? Because he ate my flesh and he drank my blood. But I'm going to show you another way to this. As a living Father sent me, and I live because of the Father, so watch this, he who feeds on me will live because of me. This is the bread which came down from heaven, not as your fathers ate the manna and are dead. He who eats this bread will do what? Live. Jesus was not speaking figuratively. He was speaking rather figuratively. But they were taking it literally. And you understand the Jews were prohibited from touching blood. The Bible said that the life of man is well in his blood. What Jesus was literally saying, that if you have faith in me and come to me and receive me, I will raise you up in the last day. Somebody shout revelation. That's why when the last supper came, the disciples didn't have no problem eating, Lord have mercy, and drinking. Because they understood on a greater level that this meant everlasting life, that if I would receive him into me, he would receive me. Watch this, verse 60. Therefore, many of his disciples, remember the 70 that we saw over there? Many of his disciples, watch this, when they heard this, said, this is a hard saying. Who can understand it? Watch this. When Jesus knew in himself that his disciples complained about this, he said to them, does this offend you? What then if you should what? See the Son of Man ascend where he was before. It is the Spirit. That's why you need him. You need the Holy Spirit. It is the Spirit who gives life. The flesh profits you what? Nothing. The words that I speak to you, listen, they are spirit and they are life.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
But there are some, watch this, there are some of you who do not believe. Somebody shout, this is what faith needs to take place. Some of you who do not believe. For Jesus knew, watch this, from the beginning, who they were, who did not believe. And who would betray him. Watch this. And he said, therefore, I have said to you that no one can come to me unless it has been granted to him by my Father. You think you can just walk up on me and talk about, I'm saved, I'm sanctified, I believe? No, if my Father don't draw you.
Come on down.
In fact, Paul says, no man can call Jesus Lord except by the Holy Spirit. Now watch this, verse 66. From that time, many of his disciples went back and walked with him no more. Sometimes this thing can get gruesome and grievous. But yet you got to be able to look through what it is that God is trying to show you. Then Jesus said to the disciples, do you also want to go back? But Simon Peter answered him, Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. Also, we have come to believe and know that you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. Jesus answered them, Did I not choose all 12 of y'all, and one of y'all is the devil? Matthew 28 chapter. We're getting ready to get out of here. Matthew 28 chapter, are you there? Watch this. Jesus did not give this power to all 72. He did not give the power to the, he only gave the power to the 11. Even Judas being the devil that we just saw, he did not give him power. He gave him opportunity. He did not give him power. He gave him opportunity to accept him and to walk with him, but he rejected him. Now watch this. Then the 11, you see that in verse 16, 28 and 16? Then the 11, Judas is gone. Then the 11 disciples went away and got into Galilee to the mountain which Jesus had appointed for them. When they saw him, they did what? They worshiped him, but some doubted. Isn't that amazing? Worshiping and doubting. Watch this. And Jesus came and spoke to them, saying, all authority, here it is. All authority has been given unto me where? In heaven and in earth. Now what is he about to do? He's about to send them. He's about to commission them. He says, because the authority is in me, I am authorizing you. I'm giving you power to do what? Go. And do what? Make disciples. Go and make learners. That's what a disciple is. He is a learner. He is a pupil. He is a student. He says, go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and of the Holy what? Spirit, teaching them to observe all things that I have what? Commanded you. And lo, I am with you even until the end of the earth. Peter could preach with boldness. Watch this. Because he's been endowed with power from on high. The power and exploits wrought by the hands of the apostles at Pentecost was possible because, watch this, the disciples followed the instructions of Jesus. Somebody shout, you got to learn how to follow the instructions. Jesus said to them in Luke 24 and 49, behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you. But he says, tarry in the city of Jerusalem until you are what? Endued with power. Listen, we don't need power. You're not going to be able to live out the rest of your life without the power of the Holy Spirit. You need him. The greater one lives within. If we don't understand that, listen, y'all, we're going to be a wreck for the rest of our days. Power for living.
Yeah.
When you have power for living, it leads to powerful living.
Yeah.
When you have power for living, because you cannot live absent from the power of God. absent from the power of the Holy Spirit. Power for living leads to powerful living. Have you ever just sit back and watch somebody who is in the will of God and say, God, I wish I could operate like that? Examples of people who took God at his word. Everybody standing. Power for living. Sometimes we're asking God for power without prayer. Sometimes we're asking God for power without fasting. We're asking God for power without commitment. We're asking him for power without fellowship. We're asking him for power and yet we're doubting. The Bible speaks to us on this wise in Acts the 19th chapter, whereby there are seven sons of Sceva, of vagabond Jews who operate in magic. The Bible says during this time they're taking a handkerchief from Paul's body and they're laying it on the sick and they're recovering. They're laying in his shadow and people are recovering. And these vagabond Jews, witches, that's what they were. They were looking at Paul. And the Bible says that they walked up on a man who was demon possessed. And they said, we adjure you. We command you in the name of Jesus to come out. The demons looked at the man and said, Jesus, we know. Paul, we know. But who are you? Power without prayer. Power without praise. Power without fellowship. Power without unity. Power without insight. Power without revelation. Power without fasting. Power without prayer will only lead to destruction.
Yeah.
Simon the sorcerer saw Peter operating in the Holy Spirit. The Bible said that he was a powerful man, for he went around to bewitch the people all over the city. And when Peter came operating in the Holy Spirit, he came and asked, how much can I pay you for that? Peter had to tell him to repent because death was knocking at his door. He would turn to Peter and ask Peter to intercede for him. The difference between Samson and those in the Old Testament over against those of us who are in the New Testament is that the Spirit came upon them, but the Spirit came to live within us. So that when the Spirit was through using them, God would lift His Spirit off of them. But now He tabernacles with us. He dwells in us. He dwells with us. He keeps us.
Yes.
Thank God for the Holy Spirit, because had it not been for the Holy Spirit, y'all, the convictions, watch this, that we have, they'd be absent.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, Lord.
Your conscience wouldn't be working.
Thank you, Lord.
Be seared with a hot iron. But thank God.
Thank you, Lord. God.
He allows us to feel conviction.
Thank you, Jesus.
We need power for living.
Yes.
I'm tired of church as usual.
Yes, Lord.
That's what we've been waiting on. We're waiting on the pandemic to just go and blow over so we can go back to what is usual. God said, no. Y'all don't even understand. This thing is lingering. If the church collectively around the world, I say this as a man of God, if the church, the collective ecclesia,
yeah,
if we, the body of Christ, got together and called a corporate day of fasting, shut the government down, shut jobs down, shut homes down around the world, and we come with a corporate prayer. Watch this. COVID wouldn't stand a chance. The killing and the murdering that we see wouldn't stand a chance. He says, I've given you power over all the power of the enemy. In other words, he says, when you pray in the Holy Spirit, you're not competing, you dominating.
Amen.
We keep competing. God says, I want domination. That's why we can't get on one accord in the church, because everybody in the church ain't got the Holy Spirit. But Paul says the feeble members among you bestow more honor. Spend more time with them. Disciple them, walk with them. I'm going to another level. Look at your name and shout, I'm going to another level. Come on, tell them. I'm to another level. And I'm telling them, I'm not just saying this. Because if you ain't going with me, that's fine. We got to cut ties tonight. I can't drag you. I can't carry you into the next year. I got to sever the connection now. I don't want to be popular. I want to be powerful. If my name is never called, if I never speak or preach before thousands, I'm fine. So long as when it's all said and done, I hear servant.
Well done.
Servant, well done.
Thank the Lord.
I'm not here to make friends. I'm not here to make connections and do all this networking. I'm not here for that. Had all of that in the infancy stages of my ministry. I've been there, and that's what I've been trying to get people to understand. Listen, I've been around long enough. I'm an old coon. I'm old. I know I still look young, but I'm old. Restoration gave me all this grace, and the grace that you don't see up here, praise God. But he said his wisdom. The Bible called it hoary hairs. It's wisdom. Some of it is stress. Amen. My son looked at me on Christmas, and I walked in with all the children in the family, and he looked at me, he said, dang, man. Looking like, what, son? He said, Dad, man, all of your hair over there great. Like, oh man, like it's white, man. I'm like, Daddy, man, what do? They're going to show you. Sometimes people don't pay attention. It's been white for a long time. Sometimes I look in the mirror and say, God, thank you. I'm telling you tonight, God wants to give you power. You need that power. For living. And if you come into 2022 same way, it ain't nobody fault but yours. Nobody fault but yours. Ain't taking no prisoners. Amen. I'm shooting the wounded. Y'all ain't hear me. Not in 2022. No, I ain't carrying nothing. Nothing but vision. Nothing but purpose. Nothing but the plans of God. Hallelujah. I pray tonight something was said and done tonight to help those of you who are watching online. Listen. God is doing exploits and he wants to use you. You don't have to have a microphone. You don't have to have a platform. You don't have to have a title to be used by God. Not in this season. God wants to use you if you avail yourself to him. Ask him for power to live. Power to govern yourself and to keep yourself in his will. Ask ask him for, he'll give it to you. I promise you, he'll give it to you. We're getting ready to give tonight. I'm going to ask for a special seed. Those that trust the Lord tonight with $22, we're going into 2022. We're just going to trust God. Amen, somebody. We're going to trust them. Those of you who are online, you can find us Giblify, Restoration Outreach Church, down on Giblify. Amen. $22. Let's believe God as we seed into the kingdom tonight. We're seeding into our destiny. We're seeding into our purpose. We're seeding into the will of God for our lives. We're seeding into the kingdom. But there shall be a harvest. There shall be a harvest. Yes. Yeah. Been able to see you guys on the last day of the year.
Yeah.
We had service early so that we can get out early. I don't want to put anybody in danger. Right? We know that there's going to be a lot of shooting and a lot of things going on tonight, but we bind murder.
Yeah.
We bind robbery. We bind rape, we bind carjacking, in the name of Jesus. That in our community, there shall be peace. No loss of life, in the name of Jesus. Safety, in the name of Jesus. Let us continue to pray. We have some members who are out, and they have been affected by the virus. Let's pray for them. Let's pray with them. But not just them. People across the world.
Yes.
Let's keep ourselves safe.
Amen.
Let's keep ourselves safe. We believe that God has so much more in store for us that we're going to live and fulfill the will of God over our lives. I just believe that. Amen.
Oh, yes.
I just believe it. Amen. I want to say thank you to my nephew who came and sat in on the night. Y'all, well done, nephew. Amen. Y'all know me, just knee high to a grass out. Amen. Boy got more hair on his face than I do now. Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank God for him sitting in on tonight for us. We're getting ready to leave. Tonight, put some requests in for God. For the new year, have a level of expectation that he's going to do it. But more importantly, let's submit and surrender ourselves to the Lord so that there will be nothing that will withhold nor hold up the blessings and the requests in which we're making known before him. We're getting out in good time, and amen. Go home and enjoy our families.
Yeah.
Amen. Let's remember the Daniel fast starts in the morning.
Yeah.
Amen. Saturday. No, Saturday. For the next 21 days. Can't get right. Amen.
Yeah.
It's always one.
Always
one. Always one. Praise the Lord. Starts in the morning. Amen. For the next 21 days. We're going to be believing God for some extraordinary things.
Yes,
some extraordinary things. The second and fourth Saturday of this month at 10 a.m. Those of you who are watching, if you would like to come in and pray with us, we're going to have intercessory prayer. The second and the fourth Saturday at 10 a.m. You're going to also join in with us on the Daniel fast. If you've never been a part of the Daniel fast, if you would like for us to sing you what we are taking in and what we're not taking in. You can inbox Lady Bailey, myself, or any other member of Restoration that you may know, and we'll get that to you. Amen? Amen. Let's pray. God, we thank you for what has transpired in this place on tonight. Thank you for this last night of the year that you've allowed us to be assembled here, unified in your presence.
Yes. Thank you.
Symbolic to bring the new year together.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
As we leave here tonight, God, will you be so kind to go with us? Give us safe travel.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord. Can we make it back to our many different homes and destinations? Can we find them as we have left them? Cover Memphis.
Cover us, oh God.
Cover Memphis, God.
Yes, God.
Paralyzed murderers tonight, God. Not physically, God. Paralyze their ability to get out and kill tonight. Robbers, paralyze them in the spirit. The spirit of murder that is over our city, we bind down and shackle in the name of Jesus. Satan is a liar.
Yes, he is.
He cannot have our children.
Thank you, Lord.
We give them back to you.
Yes, God. Good to see you, Lord.
You said, suffer the kids to come unto me and forbid them not.
Yes.
Such is the kingdom of God.
Yes,
God. Now go with us.
Go with us.
Allow your spirit to travel with us, God. We not just pray for Memphis. We pray for every city in the United States of America.
Yes.
We pray for our government. We pray for religious leaders, God. We pray for community leaders. God, we pray for political leaders. That we will collectively integrate, cross lines, and begin to fight this thing together. We love you. And we bless you. In Jesus' name. Happy New Year. Bless you.